order to set up the guy or the individual. To set up the individual. He said, أَمَّا الذبح للأكل. As now slaughtering to eat. As now slaughtering to eat. Now I want the brothers to count down on these things that we're about to say. As thou, as in regard to slaughtering to eat, number one. أو الذبح لإكرام الضيف or to slaughter to honor a guest because a person has a guest in his slaughter alhamdulillah to what? To honor his guest. He got a guest, he will slaughter the biggest animal in the what you call it? In the barn? In the farm, right? Oh, no, not in the farm. You know, sometimes people they have a big old what you call it? Small, how you call it? A barn?
Yeah,
huh? Yeah, on the back of the house or stuff like the way they keep the good big animals and stuff like this. So they have a guest, alhamdulillah, and they, you know, they just slaughter one, barakallahu feekum, just because they're happy to see their guest or they wanna, and they treat him that because he's their guest and they love him and they honor him. So they you know, slaughtering an animal, a goat or a sheep, alhamdulillah, ikraman lahu, to show respect and to treat him well or to welcome him. Number three. But with all of this, number two, right? Number one was what?
To eat.
Number two is to?
A guest.
And number three, the Shaykh Hafidhullah didn't mention this, but Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah mentioned in Usul al-Thalatha. That's why, alhamdulillah, it is important that we start with the beginning, right? With the beginning and move up. And when we start with the beginning has to be concrete, man. Has to be, alhamdulillah, understood thoroughly. So the third one, the Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah mentioned in regard to the types of slaughtering. The permissible types of slaughtering is what? To slaughter to sell. To slaughter to sell. To slaughter to sell. Let's say the individual, he's, you know, he's broke. He got to pay his rent or stuff like that. He got a big animal in there. He said, okay, let me just slaughter this and sell, you know, sell to the people. Oh, that's his job. He's a butcher. He slaughter, he go to the farm, take an animal, slaughter, because he want to sell, aid the people. So, yep. So these, barakallahu fikum. And the fourth one was that, to slaughter in regard to having a newborn baby. Slaughtering for the newborn baby. Right? Yes, this is what the Shaykh Hafidhahullah Ta'ala mentioned in it. So therefore, these are the four types of slaughter that are permissible, barakallahu fikum. Right? And of course, the slaughtering of the aqiqah goes along with the udhiyah. Huh? Yes, in this, yes. So here we're mentioning about the types of permissible slaughtering. طيب. So the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, this first one he mentioned, أَمَّا أَذَّبْحَ لِلْأَكَلْ, as far as slaughtering to eat, and then slaughtering and to honor the guest, he say, while it is being mentioned the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say, فَهَذَا لَا بَأْسَ بِهِ, there is no problem with this. As long as the individual mentioned the name of Allah, there is no problem with this. لأنه, but there is a نقطة here to be mentioned here, أو الذبح لإكرام الضيف, that slaughtering is not to be done as some people they are doing it, that they will slaughter on the feet of the individual. They will slaughter the animal on the feet of the individual. They will slaughter the animal under the feet of the individual. Meaning the person will come and they will stand up right there under his feet and slaughter him. This, barakallahu feekum, can lead to acts of shirk wal-iyadu billah. That can lead to ta'zeeman li ghayrillah, to be glorified other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, he say, if it is, wa yudhkaru alayhi ismullah, if it is mentioned the name of Allah, fahadha la ba'sa bihi, there is no problem into this. لِأَنَّهُ مِنَ الْعَادَاتِ La min al ibadat, because this slaughtering, it is from the customary action, not from the actions of worship. So we have to make a difference between the adat and the ibadat. Eating, barakallahu fikum, eating and drinking, it is from the matters that are the adat. It is from the adat. So here, the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, he categorized the type of slaughtering. He brought first the slaughtering that are عادات, the customary actions. طيب وأما الذبح الأضحية والذبح العقيقة, he say as in regard to the slaughtering that is pertaining to the أضحية, meaning the sacrifice of the عيد of عيد الأضحية, the بانا سلة as they call it, the بانا سلة, بانا بانا بانا. طيب as far as in the بانا سلة or the أضحية or the تبسكي or the عيد الأضحية or the عيد of the sacrifice, and likewise the sacrifice of the for the newborn baby, for the newborn baby. And as the hadith that mentioned about barakallahu fikum, two for a boy and one for a girl, two for a boy and one for a girl. And as the ulama, they mentioned that the sacrifice has to be done 7 days after the birth, if it is the seventh day from the birthday, طيب, including meaning when you count it, we count the day where the baby was born, as long as it was before Maghrib. And likewise, if it couldn't be done in the seventh day, the individual doesn't have the means to do the seventh day, he will carry out the 14th day, right? The 14th day. If he doesn't have the means to do the 14th day, he will shoot for the 21st day. طيب, 21st day. And after the 21st day, barakallahu fikum, it is open for whenever he could do it, if he can do it. طيب. So, والذي, he said, وذبح الذي يقصد به العبادة. And likewise, this act, this sacrifice, that the intent is the act of worship. He said, فهذا عبادة لله عز وجل. This slaughtering or this sacrifice, it is an act of worship for Allah alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولا يذبح للمخلوق. And the servants or the creatures, they should not be slaughtered for. He said, تعظيما له, out of venerating them or magnifying them or glorifying them. He said, تعظيما, تعظيم, he said, له تعظيم عبادة. He said, because التعظيم or تعظيم عبادة, to glorify, it is the act of worship. So therefore, ولا يذبح, it is not to be slaughtered عند قبر, upon a grave, or a grave of a person, meaning a grave of a makhluq, a grave of a person. So no one from the creatures, no one from the human being should not be from their grave or in their grave or in their grave site. No one should be slaughtered in their grave site. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. You say, لِأَنَّ هَذَا, because that slaughtering, it is, barakallahu fikum, a act of worship. It is an act of worship. It is something that is an act of worship. It is an act of worship. And number two, that no one should be slaughtering for other than Allah, meaning for slaughtering in the grave, because that slaughtering in the grave could be, barakallahu fikum, has some effect on the people that are witnessing that. Meaning it could direct them to be slaughtering, to be thinking that slaughtering for other for in the grave, it is something that is an act of worship. So therefore, the people seeing this, they will see, well, if this individual is slaughtering for in this grave or in this grave site, that could mean what? That this individual has some type of divine power. Divine power, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. So slaughtering for a person in the grave will mean that this is act of worship in his regard. Right? That's why the Shafi'i, he say, لِأَنَّ هَذَا, he say, يُؤَوِّلُ إِلَىٰ عِبَادَتِهِ, it is to be showing or to be indicating that it is being worshipped, meaning that individual in the grave is being worshipped. So therefore, that this matter of slaughtering, it is something that, alhamdulillah, we have to understand. And we have to, alhamdulillah, very much, and in talking to our family members with this, the slaughtering for other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because now the people, everything that they do, it is about slaughtering. Everything that they do, it is about slaughtering. Even if the individual, he dream about slaughtering an animal, for him he has to go and slaughter an animal. When was the dream? When did it become a way of legislation? When was the dream become a way of legislation? A person will dream about, you know, giving sadaqa milk. So the next day he's going to get up and give sadaqa for milk. So this is not for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the ulama, they mentioned the shirk is very, very minute, meaning very fine. So the individual, the talibul ilm, the person, the individual that is upright upon the tawheed of Allah, he has to know the detail, the fine points of a shirk in order to avoid it. The shirkul khafi, the shirk that is so tiny and very small to the point that the individual, it require, barakallahu fiqh, a good tarbiyah. It require a good, alhamdulillah, yani a methodology of learning and teaching to understand those points of shirk. So this matter, barakallahu fikum, of slaughtering in the grave, we say, as Sheikh Fawzan mentioned, that it can fall into two categories, right? The ruling of slaughtering in the grave can be in two categories. Number one, Abdullah. That the slaughtering in the grave site could fall into two ruling. Number one,
it can be, I mean, if the person do it for the person that is the grave, it's going to be a shirk.
Tayyip, he say, if a person is slaughtering ta'ziman, glorify the individual in the grave, that this is shirk.
If you do it for the shirk of Allah, it's going to be bid'ah.
Very good. He says, see, you're doing it for the sake of Allah, but you're doing it in the grave, it is bid'ah. How is it a bid'ah?
Because the place.
Very good. Because al-makan, because of the place. This is, I think we understand this. Tayyip, how about, what are the types of al-dhabh al-adi? I will, yani naam, al-dhabh al-adat. The slaughtering that are from the customary action. Aba Asma.
To eat.
To honor a guest. Another one. No, the slaughtering that are act of customary action. No, last one. No, this is the fall into a ibadah. Yes, to sell. To eat, to honor a guest, and to sell. To eat, to honor a guest, and to sell. These are the slaughtering that are permissible under one condition. What is the condition?
If you don't.
The condition is that you mention the name of Allah. The condition here is to mention the name of Allah. Tayyip, amma the slaughtering that are acts of worship. The slaughtering that are acts of worship.
For
Eid. Right, for the Eid? What Eid? Because people be slaughtering for the Eid of Fitr. Udhiyah, yes. Udhiyah, number two. For the aqiqah, na'am, number three.
For
aqiqah, for the newborn baby.
Oh, okay.
Huh? Right, this is the intent of the ibadah, of course. This is the intent of the ibadah, now. Well, because the walima is not a must that the individual slaughter a animal,
okay. Right?
You feed the people of what you have. But if awling walau bishat, this is also a hadith that is authentic, where the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam told one of the Sahaba, yani give the walima even if it is a goat or something like this. But this barakallahu fikum falls in under, yani the customary actions, the customary action because of. It is not something that is a mandatory to do so. No.
Oh man, the one for the another, you want to make a vow.
Right, a person can slaughter for a vow. A person can slaughter for a vow.
Does that fall in the worship?
Yes, taba'an, because that the vow itself is the worship. So you can make the vow to give a bottle of water, right? Here the worship actually here is not the giving of the bottle of water, but rather the fulfillment of the vow. You understand? You can vow to slaughter a camel, just like Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu, when he vowed to slaughter a camel when he was in Jahiliyyah. Tayyip. But here, barakallahu fikum, the ibadah is the fulfillment of the vow. I can vow to give a bottle of water. Tayyip. So giving the bottle of water, alhamdulillah, yes. But what is the ibadah here? Is